A very good evening to all of you. We welcome all. Today, we welcome our speaker, Dr. Jyoti R. Vivandkar, consulting homeopath, BHMS Mumbai, practicing since 25 years in Mahim, UK certified user of back flower remedies, passionate user of biotissue salts, counseling psychologist, and a Hast Mudra therapist. Felicitated by BMC in Mumbai for work done in Dharavai as a COVID Yodha, April 2020. Moderator for various CMEs conducted by Medical Practitioners Association. So she'll be today taking us through the journey of back flower remedies. She will be teaching us the introduction to the back flower remedies. Her topic for the day is healing the mind with back flower remedies. We welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Am I audible, Akshita?
Proper? Yes, ma'am, you are audible. Perfect.
Okay.
So anyone has queries, we'll take in the end of the session. You can keep posting so that we don't disturb the flow of the thoughts. So let's be on mute and please don't unnecessarily unmute yourself, please. Okay, ma'am, you can continue.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Akshita. And welcome. Thank you for all joining in. Before I start, I would first once again thank Akshita for the kind words which she has used. Today what we are going to do is understand what is back flower remedies. Many of us have only heard, few of them practice, and few of them are completely unaware. And there are a group of people who are using it but not knowing the particular reason. So I have tried to put things together from various books and my experiences for all of you so that you understand the importance of the BFR, that is the batch flower remedies. So everything starts right from the name, you see, right from the name. So should I share my screen, doctor?
Yes, ma'am, definitely you can share. Anyone has queries can raise their hands in the long run, but please don't unmute yourself. Yes, ma'am, it's visible. Yes. Absolutely. Yes. Perfect.
Yes.
But can we go for a slide preview? Yeah, perfect, yeah. Ma'am.
Okay,
perfect.
Fine. Okay, full screen. No, that's fine. Okay, so before I start, like you can read the slide, heal the mind with back flower remedies. I always start whichever session of mine with a small prayer. You can join in if you wish to, okay? Vakratunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samaprabha Nirvignam Kurumer Devo Sarvakaryeshu Sarvada.
Ma'am, please can you check the volume? It's very low at your side.
Is it?
Yes.
Now?
Ma'am.
Now?
It's much better.
Better? So I think I'll have to hold it, looks like. Doesn't matter. So this was a small prayer which I generally start off with every time. And today being Tuesday, we worship Lord Ganesh. And as we know that he is the one who takes care of all the obstacles in our lives. Do you agree? So you can... Akshita, like you very well said to everyone that let's not put in questions as of now. Let us be with the good flow and see what all we have to offer. And at the end of it, definitely I am there to take up all your questions. Okay? So as I'm going through, and you can see, yeah, this I have just put up to tell you that I have been practicing back flower remedies since quite some time, more than 10 years. And along with graphology, that is hand writing analysis, along with yoga and Hasta Mudra therapy. Now what that is, I'll slowly tell you as and when the time comes in, right? What I want to tell you is back flower, which you all know, has been practiced in more than 40 countries all over the world. You won't believe that many countries are aware of these remedies. Now, if you want to know why I got into this or what brought me into this is a little story. Before that, I'll tell you the story of Dr. Edward Batch. Now, he is the one who is the founder, who was the one responsible to give us this beautiful therapy, right? So Dr. Edward Bach, as you can read, born September 24, 1886, was a bacteriologist, physician, pathologist, and born in Birmingham, England, studied at the University College London and had also obtained a diploma in public health service. I want to tell you a little story before we go to the next slide. Is he came from a family of very poor persons. You know, they used to work in a foundry, and there were quite a few children, and the parents couldn't afford education.
I'm again voice.
Okay, voices.
Yeah,
okay, is
now
that okay?
Stop
I think
it.
I think working. Yeah, yeah.
Very sorry.
No. It's absolutely okay. Absolutely good. You told me. So yeah, if this is okay, I'll think I'll just hold on to this.
This is perfect, actually.
Yeah, good. So like I said, Dr. Edward Bach came from a very poor family, working in a foundry for his livelihood along with his other siblings and his parents too. But he was a very humorous child and a very intelligent child and always loved to be in the nature. Looking at his capabilities and his intention to always become a medico, somehow they managed to put him into a medical college. Okay. I think...
I'll take care. You keep on...
Yeah. So this is what happened. And then when he went into the medical college, he passed out with a degree of MBBS, like you can see, studied at the University College, with very good ranks. And he started practicing as a bacteriologist, as a physician, always the interest of working towards something new. But something always bothered him, and that was why people are suffering in spite of giving this kind of medicines. So slowly and steadily, his interest started diverting, and he took admission for homeopathy in homeopathic college in London. He graduated himself as a homeopath there. And there he came across this, when he read about the Organon and studied about it in depth, he realized that the basic concept of everything was similia similibus curanda, which all of us are aware of, right? We work on those principles. He thought this is something which is so much different than what other modern practices or other practitioners are doing, because that is involved with a lot of pain and suffering. Whereas this is giving a very steady understanding of a system, and healing process is beautiful. When he was studying homeopathy and he finished his homeopathy, by then he was very much recognized in the world of medical fraternity as a very good allopath as well as a homeopath. Slowly he involved himself into more of research, and he came across a vaccine which he found and gave the whole world. Now when he was doing this, he thought now this could be something which could be more beneficial for everyone. Okay? But slowly he realized that again the suffering is not taken care of. Why? Because there is something else to it. So he started going into the nature and started finding new therapies. That's when he came across beautiful flowers. And he started doing his research more and more. And he realized that by working on these flowers by different methods, they could be made use of in medicinal form. Okay? And that's where he found that the energy is stimulated by these essences of flowers. And these were responsible to take care of the emotions, which was again the basic principle of homeopathy, which he was very much attuned with. And what he realized that these valuable energy is heightened by taking good remedies, which is in the form of flowers. That's where the 12 healers came into the picture. Okay, the first 12 flower remedies came into the picture. Then he worked more and more, and he realized that there is lots to do with evolving newer medicines and give it to the world. But at that time, he was diagnosed of a tumor at a very young age. And after the investigation, he was given only 3 months to live for life. Without any consent of the hospitalized authority, he left the hospital, came back and went into the laboratory, and he said, nothing doing. I'm going to be one with nature, right? In nature, when he started finding newer flowers and kept doing research day in and day out in that room. He never did anything outside that for months together, years together. And within a few years, he realized that he is absolutely cured of it. Absolutely fine. That was the time he felt this is something unique and this should be made a mention of and written in theoretical form so that it can be used. So this is how actually batch flower remedies came into the picture. Now again, there is a question in everyone's mind. Why am I saying batch and not bark or back? Well, he was famous in his college as Batch. Everybody used to say Batch, and that stayed back, that glued on to him. So he's well known as Dr. Edward Batch, okay, and not Bach. This you realize only when you study the theory, when you understand the history, and that's very important. That's very important. Now I again want to go back to this slide to tell you this is how it started spreading more and more into various countries of teaching. Okay? And even he had a lot of people, his friends accompanied him and gave him assistance in not only research, but also spreading the knowledge amongst lots of people. Lots of people. That's the history. Now, when I go back to this, now I will say, why have I put up this slide? I have to tell you my story here. You will say, why did I come into batch? If I'm a homeopath, why didn't I stick to it? Well, I've been practicing homeopathy for the last 24 years, like you know. But what happened is, when I had an incident in my life somewhere in 2004-05, when I was diagnosed with intramural fibroid. I used to always have this menstrual cycle issue, and that was the time I had to remove, I was supposed to and I was forced to remove the uterus. But it was young age, so they said if the ovaries are fine, you have to retain it. And that's how I retained with my ovary. But then of course I was very fine because my menstrual cycles were not bothering me as it bothers so many of the ladies and obstructs our work. So I was like in a very happy state of mind, okay. As the days went by and I was in my happy mood of being a very good homeopath, practicing well, and being a very good social person, having my own good time, and passionately dancing, which I love doing. That's my first hobby. Having my own painting sessions, lots into fitness, and teaching fitness to people. I had my own classes. Not from my side. There is somebody's mic. Not from my side.
Ma'am, it's from your side only. Otherwise, all around me.
See, it's gone. Somebody had. Okay. Am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am. Perfect.
Okay. Thank you once again. So this is how my got into my state, and then I was struck by cancer in 2009. That time, one question just struck to me. What happened? If I have such beautiful life, I'm enjoying, I love what I do, I enjoy with my family and my friends, and I love being a practitioner, healing so many people, what happened? So I started thinking about it. Okay, went on with my treatment, had to go all the therapies, the surgery, the chemotherapy and the radiation and all of that. But I had a lot of time to think, right? Because only one thing I did at that point of time is submitted myself to the Almighty, to my family, to my friends, and to my doctor. That's what I did. I told them, I'm not going to look into any of these matters, which medicine they are giving me, why they are giving me, what they are giving me. I don't want to know about it. I'm just going to follow what I've been told. Just before this had happened, no, somewhere in 2006 and 7, I had already read a lot about batch flower remedies. I had already started putting it into use. I used to get a lot of books from libraries and things like that. And I used to talk to a lot of seniors and had started putting in this work into my practice, but only knowing the remedies, okay? Like at many of y'all, like not knowing the deeper part of it, though it was giving me results, but the understanding was not very clear. In 2010 and 11, when my therapy was going on, I started reading more and more. And being an avid traveler, after all my treatment was done, with the opportunity of traveling the globe, I did my bachelor course from London, and I realized and understood what is the in-depth study. And that was the time even I realized that emotions play a very, very strong role in giving you a physical ailment. For sure. Whatever it could be, whatever it could be. And that's how my study deepened. That's how my study deepened. I passionately got involved more and more into the biotissue salts as well as batch flower remedies into my homeopathic practice. And then I saw that the results were amazing. Whenever there were blocks or whenever it had to be started, whenever. So I thought I must share this personal story with you to understand something similar happened with me the way it happened with Dr. Batch, right? And that's the reason I got into batch flowers. Now let me go ahead. Yes. So according to him, his work, what did it say? That physical symptoms seen in the body is a mirror reflecting the thoughts in mind. The sufferer needs to overcome these disturbing thoughts. Just what I told you in my story and what you heard from the history of Dr. Batch, right? So a gentle and natural effective way was required rather than the pain and the suffering in a very subtle and a harmonious flow. That is what was required more than harming a patient who is already a sufferer because of his ailment, right? He believed that ill health is due to disharmony within our mind. So it is very important to treat the mind. Now all the homeopaths out here will synchronize or echo with the same thought, because this is what we do when we do our case taking. We try to find the constitutional medicine by understanding the person and his mind, right? Of course, the physical plays a lot of importance in treating, but to understand the mind. So he suggested healing of a sick person rather than the sick body. Once again, a similarity. Being a homeopath, like I said, there was a lot of complementary things which were happening. And that was because his focus had shifted from the painful journey to a harmonious journey. From modern medicines or any other practice which he did earlier to the practice of homeopathy as well as batch flowers. So good health is harmony when person is thinking positively and constructively, right? So this plays a vice versa role. So whenever the thoughts are good, body is good. When the body is good, thoughts are good, right? Imagine what happens if it is not so. So now when I'm wanting to tell you, this is about the concept of the batch flower remedies. This is how it is based on, right? So basically, the personality types holds the most important place here. Now this personality, which we understand during our case taking or when we are trying to figure out the personality, is selected according to emotional outlook, mood, temperament, which is a very characteristic of an individual. Once again, like we say in homeopathy, we come across the PQRS symptoms, right? Which are the most striking for us. We take up those, right? So here it is more of the emotional outlook, the moods and the temperaments. The body which shows the physical symptoms is just a mirror reflecting all the thoughts, okay? So that person, the sufferer, the person who is having the ailment, needs the treatment basically to overcome all these disturbing thoughts. Now what it could be in different forms, right? So in the forms of maybe fears, depressions, worry, anxiety, lot of this. Now each remedy which he has discovered deals with one human emotion. One human emotion. But I must tell you, at one point of time in us as a human being, we could have various emotions at different stages, even in a day. What we are in the morning need not be the same what we are in the evening or in the afternoon. Our moods might keep changing, and it does, and it does. That's why he found that for each and every emotion, there is a flower to come to our aid. Okay? So, now, we realize this till here, till the concept of bachelor or till the concept of homeopathy, there was no science or a link to make others understand how it is useful, how it works. And now it is a proven fact. Now it is absolutely a proven fact, which comes by the name of the psychoneuroimmunology. Why? Because this shows us the link between the emotional health, the immune system, and the nervous system. As you can see, we know whenever there is a stress occurring in the body or in the mind, or whenever with an organism, let's say with an organism, what we see, what gets affected? What gets affected? The immune system, the endocrine system, and also the nervous system. And they in turn are related to each other. Now let me tell you about the endocrine system. We know if that gets disturbed, it affects our glands, that is the thyroid, the adrenals, the gonadal, all of that. And we see a lot of cases coming up these days with PCOS, or a lot of issues coming with thyroid, right? At the same time, as we see, the stress factor gives rise or problem to the immune system. I don't think in the present scenario I must even tell you how immune system gets affected. COVID, which is happening as of now, which has taken everybody by shock. The most important thing which we are seeing in the forms of inflammations, infections, allergies, pains, all of this. And what is it? It's a cytokinase change. That's why in between, when we were talking about the COVIDs, the cytokinase storm and how to handle it. So the immune system played a very important role when a stress factor is there and when there is a link between the endocrine and the immune system. Now, when this immune system also is getting disturbed, as we know, there are neurotransmitters. The nerves play an important role to transmit certain energy, parasympathetic, sympathetic, as we all know. And the cytokinase storm have a link. That's how we see the difference happening in our nervous system. And what are the symptoms, or how does it get reflected? In the forms of the expression of the nervous system is the anxiety, depression, and physically or emotionally, there is a lot of difference happening in maybe appetite pattern or sleep patterns. All of that gets affected. And that's how, if I may tell you, even when we are seeing COVID patients, a lot of them have these issues. Appetite goes for a toss. Their sleep goes for a toss. They have a lot of pain and difficulty. The lungs are affected, we know it commonly. But then what causes? There is a lot of fear and anxiety even among those who have not suffered. We all know, even if a neighbor or anybody we hear of in the family is COVID positive, immediately it strikes us, oh my God, I hope it doesn't take over the family. So what happens is anxiety takes over more than the ailment. I'm sure you will agree to all these things. In the present scenario, no, in this pandemic, like we have seen so much of physical ailments, let me tell you, the nervous system which is getting affected is on the rise. Doctors, it's on the rise. We see loads and loads of people coming up with these issues more. Even if they have gone through the corona being positive and then coming back to a good system, but still disturbed emotionally. What if this happens? What if I lose my job? What if I can't travel for a long time? What if my business doesn't go the way it was going earlier? How am I supposed to take care of my family? What do I do? How do I take care of my children? Oh, I have to work at home with so many people around me. My laptop is on. My children are sitting with the mobile phone and they are studying online now. Exams, are they going to really happen? Or exams, how are the results going to be? Online? Are there going to be anything related with exams? Everything starts coming to your mind. So basically, it's the thoughts which are getting affected and showing different symptoms. In, like I said, in the form of anger or anxiety. And then it starts giving problem in the physical level. High blood pressure, diabetes, irritable bowel syndrome. So many things come into the foreground. Probably they may not even have suffered earlier, but now it's on the rise. So as of now, there is a fantastic proven fact with us, with homeopathy, with batch flower, that this psychoneuroimmunology link is telling us that we are in need of different therapies and not only one therapy. So a good amalgamation, a good integration of various therapies have to come together to give good results. That's where our role play is. Remember, doctors, we have to be there with them as healers. Okay, so now when I'm trying to tell you the batch flower remedies and the psychosomatic illness, like what? So the symptomatic expression, like I said, is very closely linked to the mental or the emotional and spiritual tendencies, the internal diathesis, what we say, right? All homeopaths will echo with me out here to say we see the internal diathesis of a person. Physical expressions are unresolved, and the stressful mental, emotional and spiritual conflicts always is seen. Okay, the vital force, which all homeopaths want to bring it back to a balance, expresses the psychological imbalance. How? Via certain organs and the nerve paths. Correct? That's the reason we see affections happening in organs. And then at times, like we say, we are treating pathology. We are treating with homeopathy the pathology. The organ goes for a toss. Deep-seated remedies come into the picture, or there is chronicity. And of course, the nerve paths, you see so many people with this nerve affection. So the sciaticas are there, the lumbagos are there, there are so many things. Paralysis is happening, there is cervical spondylosis, so many things happening. So the vital force starts expressing via these organs and nerve paths. So healing cannot happen unless the underlying cause which are there, they are lifted and treated very well. You will agree to this factor, because we all stress more and more about the first thing which we need to do is the case taking, right? Organon of Medicine is the book which we understand what case taking is and how to understand a person. But this subject or this has always been sidetracked by all the practitioners, especially all the young doctors. I urged them, more than coming to a simulimum or more than coming to the correct remedy, or please tell us the dosage, please tell us the potency, understand the organon. Understand the organon. What we need to lift out from the diseased condition and what needs to be treated, you will understand only when the case taking is beautiful. Only when we understand what the person is going through. And let me tell you, all the time don't try to dig in more and more into the mind when you're not getting the mind. You have to understand a person, what he or she is feeling. What he or she is feeling, okay? So, there are these groups of psychosomatic illness and its physical representation which Dr. Batch has given us, so that it becomes easier for us to derive to the remedy, the batch flower remedy, the BFR, okay? So, the over-ambitiousness, we see the power kind of people, those who are, you know, always wanting to achieve something, has given rise to coronary heart disease or the gastric or the duodenal ulcers and many more. I tried to mention a couple of them for you all. Those kind of people who experience excessive demands or overcompliance and suppression of aggressive impulses gives rise to kind of tension headaches and diabetes kind of ailments. He came across these groups and has presented it to us in a beautiful manner in his various books and theories, in which the foundation of batch flower was written, okay, along with his history. The people who are very careless in attitude or ignorant about things which is happening around, we have seen these people generally tend towards obesity. Obesity is something which clicks them or gets glued onto them. Okay? Need for attention and love these sector of people generally are seen to have asthma coming into them. Difficulty in breathing and then choking up happens to all those who are in need of some attention and love. The breathing factor gets affected. The people who are absolutely perfectionist, all they want everything to be done the way they like it or they enjoy it, like we say mentally obsessive, generally come across IBS, the irritable bowel syndrome, and many other things. IBS is very prominent in that, right? Again, the group of people who are shows instability or they have ambiguous conflicts or they have emotional maladjustments come across, or skin issues starts resurfacing, or migraine becomes an issue with them. Okay? People in a group or factors of anxiety or fear of rejection, basically, and inner uncertainty, we have seen a lot of this cardiac and skin ailments in different forms, eczema, psoriasis, so many things coming up in such category of people who have loads of fears. Again, there are types of fears, there are intensities of fears which we need to understand, and that you will understand only when you understand what a person is feeling. See, every fear doesn't fall in the same level. As I say, there is expression to it. A fear could be for something known, fear could be for something unknown. Again, the fear could go a little higher, right? Starting from an anxiety to the fear, it could say, okay, the irritation has coming. Now what? Anger has set in. Now what? So the levels can go up. Right? We have to understand that kind of state. So based on all these flowers which he came across, Dr. Bach observed following seven fundamental principles of the personal or the spiritual development, where he felt there was some error or there could have been some disturbing factor. And that is what we had to identify during our case-taking process. Right? What could that be? So he said, power is one thing where there could be some gadbad kind of a thing. Those people who have that power instinct in them, we have to investigate and find out what is taking over them. Second, he said, is the intellectual knowledge. All these category of people who are intellectually very strong, they represent different kinds of symptoms. The basic emotion of everything, the mother of all, love. The basic emotion which everybody has, that is something which gives rise to a lot of other things.
Good, good, Kitta.
Yeah. Akshita, could you just take care of this slight disturbance in between, please?
Already done, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much, sweetheart. Okay. Then we come, like his, according to the fundamental principles, the balance. So balance, according to us, as homeopaths, as you can very correctly find out, is the vital force. So we need to bring a balance in our system. If it goes above or below, we always say there is a derangement. So homeopathic medicine or batch flower medicine become complementary in achieving this balance. Service. When we say service, we are offering something. That is basically attitude of gratitude, which one needs to understand. Of course, there is this wisdom which one needs. Now, what is wisdom? So when we have our experiences together, when we have loads of knowledge about something, or we can capable of doing giving lot of information, all this put together in a sensible way will give us the wisdom for all. Only then we know and handle the situation and ourselves wisely, right? 1 minute. So when he said all these principles depends according to him, he generally categorized this in four types of patients. Okay, to him, one was the category where he has put it up as the anxious. Now, when he meant anxious, what happens? These people come up with symptoms like palpitations or digestion disturbance or dizziness or fainting spells. and they are basically a little fearful by nature. Anxiety, like I said, develops into different kinds of fears. Second category, according to Dr. Batch, was the people into the category of being angry. Now, when he says angry, what happens? These are the people who have lost control. The peace of the mind and the body is just not there. They hardly acknowledge anybody's wisdom or good things, and they are always in the denial of their own healing system. They do not want to accept whatever is told or whatever is happening around, and that's where their temper shoots up or rises. And then we come across these short-temperedness people, right? Depressive is another kind. What happens? We all know in depression, there is kind of joylessness or disinterest or lacks the enthusiasm towards life. And what happens? You see a lot of the sleep disturbance happening in these people. Or all the time they are lethargic, or a chronic fatigue syndrome occurs in these. You will always see, nahi, I am, mujhe bar nahi jana, don't call me. I'm not really interested. Okay, let's go and shop a bit. No. I really don't feel like it. Or you do what you like, leave me alone, kind of stuff. This is how it is represented. And then comes one more category, which is helpless. When we say helpless, it is similar to the kind of people who are dependent on others due to whatever things. Maybe they are ill, or maybe circumstances are such, or the situation is such, their self or in others, which makes them feel very helpless. These are the people who cannot take decisions by themselves, because they cannot, they are not capable. They have lost the determination and the vigor in their life, so much so that they feel completely helpless. Okay, and then their dependency on others starts increasing. These also can happen due to certain suppression of thoughts. Okay, so these are vague but types of patients which Dr. Batch categorized together, and then he gave us lot of emotions to understand. So now, what is the role play of Batch flower remedies in our picture? So in most cases, physical issues are treated with different systems of medicines, as we all know, and emotional problems are treated generally by what things? The psychoanalysis, the medications, the therapy, and counseling. Now, all this medication, as you all know, what happens to them? They give you their own side effects. The dullness, the drowsiness, all of that. So this is the place where our BFRs, the Batch flower remedies, plays a very, very important role. My dear friends, I really want to tell you, when we are practicing homeopathy and we know where to make use of Batch flower remedies, that is more important for us. Understand at what level this will play its role. Okay? So the approach what Dr. Batch had towards these remedies to be improved and helped and implemented in our practice is this. Each negative state of an individual is treated by encouraging the positive state to resurface and regain our natural state of health, right? So each remedy will play a peculiar emotional state. Therefore, to select one out of it, one needs to basically understand the feelings of a person. Thereby, we understand the personality type. This is what I'm trying to tell you. The personality has to be understood more than the disease. We need to know. And how he did it? So he kept his system very simple and very easy to use by an individual. He wanted it that way. So his approach was basically this. He says all the emotions are complete and perfect and are covered in all these 38 remedies. Can you believe? He's being a homeopath, in spite of understanding there are hundreds of remedies at that point of time. Today we have more than 3000 remedies, and that's why it becomes so much difficult for us to choose a remedy. But he made it so simple, because according to him, all emotions which are there are covered all in the 38 remedies. After that, he had stopped his research. He just stopped. He had torn away all his books and papers after writing his concept. So emotions have remained the same, he says. emotions have remained the same whenever it was, even in 1886 or 1936 or in 1990s or whenever we started studying our homeopathy, and even today, that is, the names of the disease have evolved. So earlier it could have been anything which we would have known as diphtheria or tuberculosis, and today what we have is cancer and COVID, but the emotions are always the reason and they remain the same. The names have evolved, the disease names have evolved, medicines have evolved, but the emotion comes from these 838 emotions and the remedies. You're getting me? He made it that simple for each one of us to use and to implement. What he did, this is to tell you what methods of preparation he had used. The sunlight flowers, sunlight method is one in which, you know, the flowers he used to keep in a bowl of water and the full sunlight was over there. So healing properties from the energy of the sun on the flowers would give in the water, and that water was used as stock. Another water, method which he used was boiling. So he soaked a bowl of the flowers in water and boiled it to a certain temperature. What happens by boiling? As we know, all the healing properties go into that water. It became the stock, and that was used as medicine. That was used for healing purposes, right? Which gave us the 38 batch flower remedies by Dr. Edward Bach. These are the names as we go. We all know about it as words, what are there, and this is easily available to you wherever it is, whichever books. I don't even want to mention it. You could read through Agrimony, Aspen, Beet, Centauri, all of that. And each one has an emotional to display. Something interesting I would just like to tell you, as you can see, oak is a remedy which we had found. And in our homeopathy, it comes by Juglans regia. We also have in homeopathy. At the same time, there is this white chestnut which she comes across. And here we have a homeopathic Aesculus hippocastinum, which we use. So we know why it is used for. Here in bachelors, we understand more deeper into how the emotional factor is there in that, especially certain chestnut remedies, okay, the nuts remedy. Okay, now I want to tell you here, since this session we are doing very much for our budding homeopaths as well as all the homeopaths who have been practicing for so long, that why should homeopaths know about BFRs? Well, the remedies which are there are given on mental or emotional indications and have the healing effect on mind as well as the body. Let me remind you, as well as the body. So the work according to a homeopathic principle where it influences the totality of the person through subtle vibrational energy related to the medicine. Okay? Once again, there is a relationship between homeopathy. The healing effect radiates through all the levels of a human being, also the physiological level. Okay? So there is a change in physiology as well as the metabolism, and that's where the role play of BFR comes. So homeopathic medicine can be added along with the BFR for a holistic cure, especially when we want to achieve good result at the physical plane too. You're getting me? That is where the homeopath should know where to use a BFR, where it plays importance. So, coming to this point, usefulness of batch flower remedies, let me tell you, all of you, it is used in all the types of cases, all, even for acutes, even in the chronic, as an intercurrent everywhere. Can be taken for a few days to a weeks or months, and then it is stopped. Then it is stopped. See, there are a few cases, if handled at the right time, the medicines given at the right point of time can be stopped within few weeks itself. A few of them whose responses are slower depending on every individual, right? It could be continued for a few months and eventually stopped. There is no need for these medicines to be given lifelong, and they are not at all addictive. Just as many of the modern medicines, people get addicted to it. You all are aware. Without taking this particular medicine, I cannot go to bed. Without taking this particular medicine, my headache just doesn't seem to go away. Without taking this particular medicine, my appetite just goes for a toss. this doesn't happen with BFRs. There is no addiction to it whatsoever. It works the moment it is given to you, and as we start seeing results, it is eventually tapered and then stopped. All the age groups one can give it, and it is absolutely safe. Absolutely safe. Okay. Important, can be taken as an adjuvant along with any other medications. Whatever the person is taking medication, you can add to it. And it has no restrictions whatsoever in the diet. And more than one can be used along with other for various stages of mind and emotion running at one point of time in one single person. That's very important. Like I said, in one particular day, each one of us could go through various emotions. Sometimes we can handle, sometimes we cannot. Some emotions are such we cannot deal with, and it turns, like I said, from anxiety to fear to rage to anger, and then it goes beyond control. A few times we feel, okay, now I'm feeling a little low. From that low, it could go once again to anxiety and to depression. There is loss of all the things in our life is what the person feels. It can go to a level of getting into suicidal tendencies too, right? Now, these plants are also very effective in plants as well as in animals. Yes, I use it loads and loads for animals. I use it for my pet. I have given it to lot of pet parents, lots of them. For any of those things. Now you'll ask me, how does it play a role for animals? Well, how could they tell us what they feel? So the person who has a pet will understand the emotion of the pet, and the way they relate it is the way we have to take it. And that's how the batch flower plays a very important role even in animals. Now how does it play an important role in plants? Yes. Plants, once again, are living. You have seen many people who talk to their plants, and they feel when they talk, they grow. And this is not stupidity. Let me tell you, my friends, it's not stupidity. Everyone needs attention and love and care and nourishment, right? So if something happens, they turn bad. They die or they crumple up. That is the time BFR comes as an aid, as an helping agent, even for plants. This is where the usefulness of batch flower is seen at various aspects in human beings, in animals, in plants, and can be given at ease. Okay? Now, actually, there is a video which I have, but it's unfortunate not playing, but it's available for you all. You could definitely watch, I'll tell you. In this picture, you could watch it on YouTube as video about Dr. Batch, and it gives us his life history, how things were going on in his life, and how he came across certain remedies initially, the 12 healers, and then how he graduated and researched more and gave us the complete picture of 38 batch flower remedies. Very, very important to each one of us. Plays an important role in the recent pandemic to take care of the emotions, even if they are COVID positive or not positive. Even after long sufferings, if they are undergoing something at the mind level, patch flower plays a very, very important role. With this, I think I've told you almost everything about what batch flower is, how it originated, the history of Dr. Edward Batch, my own past history, and I told you what derived me and my passion into it, and how I make use of it, that too very effectively. I want to end this session with the note, a little quote which I made for all of you, which says, every single person has a life to live, a work to do, a glorious personality to present, and a wonderful individuality to sustain. Ultimately, each one is unique, and I'm sure you will agree to this. Yeah, thank you. Session is open for questions.
So everyone can raise their hands for such a beautiful session. One question is, how is the dosage decided for a patient?
How is the dosage decided? Okay. Very good question, because once again we are going back to potency. As I can understand, everybody has this homeopathic question. Dosage has been standardized by Dr. Bhatt. He has been very kind with all of us. He has standardized it, you know. So when you learn about these therapy and when you learn about the medicines, the materia medica of the bachelor remedies, and when you understand the concept in the modules which we are going to put up very soon for you to all, I urge all of you to come forward and learn it at that time, slowly and steadily, how these individual remedies have to be given, at what dosage and at what repetition would be decided, because it is very simple and standardized along with the preparation. So now you don't have to boil, because I showed you the method of boiling and sunlight. You don't have to prepare it that way. I'm sure it's available in the stock form, right? It's available to us at various pharmacies in stock form, and that stock we need to make use of in our remedies. Let me tell you, in the liquid form, it is more used and not added in the pills. This is not the batch way, okay? Dr. Batch never said add it into pills and give. He made use of in the liquid form, in dilution. So each and every remedy has to be given in a liquid form. Standardization is always there. It doesn't change like the LM or the 1M or the 200. Okay, so as we learn in our module, that would be the right time to tell you the dosage.
What are the 12 main remedies in backflower? I don't think this is.
I'll tell you. Now I'll tell you, instead of quoting all those, no. When you see the video, you will get a little idea. But at the same time, the 12 healers have graduated into the 38 one. So when you understand each and every one, you need to know that 12 healers are not the only one which needs to be practiced. You need to understand all the 38. Let me tell you all the 38. But at the same time, just because you've asked this question, I'll try to understand and tell you. Agrimony, Cerato, Centauri, Chicory, Clematis, Gentian, Impatiens, Mimulus, Rockrose, Sclerinthus, Vervain, and Water Violet are the ones which were called as the 12 healers. And rest all had eventually come into the picture, which were much more effective. So it was not only limited to the 12 healers. Okay, the groups have been made by Dr. Batch, which will again, like I said, when we do up the modules, I will be telling you how to group them according to Batch's theory. Okay, yes, any more questions?
Can you suggest a few books as people are asking, except Dr. Vora, Dr. Back,
Okay,
Krishnamurti?
yeah, these are the Indian author's name, and let me tell you. I have read through various books, and that's why I could compile and put these things together and made this PPT for you all. Very frankly, very frankly. You can read all these books, but there are a lot of books coming originally from the Batch Foundation. There were a lot of his friends like Nora Weeks, there was Dr. Stephen, there was Dr. Judy Howard, there was Dr. Bodler. There are a lot of these doctors who have come up with their books, loads of them, giving lot of heal thyself. That way there are books which tells you about the initial remedies, and there are books which tells you about all the remedies. So when you compile and understand, each remedy has its own value, but when it comes to case presentation or case implementation, how to combine them or use the most important remedy, you will understand only after knowing the materia medica. That is important. So how to read and understand, that's why it needs to be taught. That's why it needs to be taught and not only read. Okay, Organon is there for us to read, or we have various repertories, but then why don't we read it and understand it, unless it was taught to us in college. Tell me, sorry Akshita to differ, but I really want to tell you one thing, all of you aspiring doctors as well as all of us also. When we start reading a repertory or a
I'm a voice.
Materia Medica book, or the repertory, I would urge you all to start reading from page number one. That's the preface. That's the place where everything written later is understood. What we do, a case comes, we take a totality, okay? Then we start repertorizing. And when we repertorize, now it's the software, then we had the books, and we go straight away to finding a rubric. We don't know how it is placed. We don't know how it is categorized. We don't know what the bold letter stands for. We don't know what is the pluses, what is the dots. We don't know. So I really, really urge each one of you that you must read the preface of every book. You will understand the internal material easily. It will be a smooth flow for each one of you, right?
I
So
think the queries will keep on coming because it's
what?
very in-depth. So we'll think about the modules. If
Yes,
it will be paid
definitely.
modules, if the people are interested, they can surely join and we can give a
Definitely.
better insight because the questions are everlasting and they are very basic questions. But once we get through it, then only I think it will be better. Like the
Very
question
much.
is when to decide for need for back flower remedies in a case. Give
Yes.
some examples of case. Please teach rescue remedy. Now it
Right,
is, I
right.
think,
Oh,
as teacher all
I will
has to be
absolutely.
done in a
Yeah.
module.
Yes.
Things we cannot answer in just an introduction class.
Absolutely, absolutely. Dr. Akshita is very correct. The reason being for that, you have to first understand the remedies. Once
Absolutely.
you
And
understand.
then only we can know the essence and rescue remedies and content of five, six remedies.
Yes.
So it is not like we can just say ki rescue remedy पढ़ लो and कोई भी ले ले. There
हाँ
has to be a lot of
नहीं,
things.
बट आई अंडरस्टैंड
मैम
व्हाई इट इज
मैम
आस्क्ड.
कैन
या
एक्सक्यूज
वन
मी
मिनट.
मैम
यस श्योर श्योर.
एक्सक्यूज मी एक्सक्यूज मी
यस
कैन यू
यस.
प्लीज स्विच
कैन
ऑन
यू
योर
प्लीज
वीडियो डियर.
रिपीट सम स्लाइड्स. कैन यू प्लीज रिपीट सम स्लाइड्स दैट सेवन फंडामेंटल प्रिंसिपल्स एंड आफ्टर दैट सम स्लाइड्स. माय
या यू
इंटरनेट
कैन गो थ्रू द
इज
एवरी
गॉन.
पेज
इट्स गोइंग टू बी
एंड एवरी
इट्स गोइंग टू बी देयर इन द यूट्यूब, राइट
पेज.
डॉक्टर अक्षिता?
Yeah, you can go to the Facebook page. You can
यस.
re-listen to this lecture, and if you find very, we'll be preparing modules sooner, and we can get through. You can ask your queries, and even you can leave your queries on the emails. You can go through the FB page. I'll just send you the details.
On YouTube by your name only, ma'am. Dr.
Homeopathic
Jyoti,
can
by
go.
your name.
Yeah.
The homeopath.
Yeah. You just
Yeah,
go
you
to the
can see.
Facebook page.
Okay. Thank you.
No problem, no problem.
Yes. See, like I said, on this platform, no, today especially, what we need to understand is what has derived or what is the basic understanding for a batch flower. To know the depth, no, you have to understand each and every remedy. And that too with its negative emotions, how the patient would represent to us, and how the remedy is going to overpower or rather come up and give the positive effect. So when batch flower is given, it doesn't mean that कोई भड़कने वाला स्वभाव है तो वो एकदम चले जाएगा एंड somebody is going to become calm. नहीं, वैसे नहीं होता. What happens is the person learns to deal with his emotions. That is what happens. So understand this basic concept. That's very important. That's very important. Any more questions you have, if you want me to
Some
take?
questions are like,
Yeah, tell
how
me,
can we
Akshita.
give it with homeopathy?
Yes, 100%. I have been using these remedies along with, rather they complement each other so well that you will see that your cases get resolved easily and much faster, much
Yes,
faster.
the time reduces beautifully. The time and the
See what happens, no? We know that an emotion is tackled. Many a times, no, these emotions itself are a hindrance in the process of our healing process when we are giving them homeopathic medicine. So when an emotional thing is catered or taken care by giving BFRs, that is the time the healing process, given the curative process by the homeopathic medicines, starts enhancing. So definitely you can give it along with it. For sure. For sure. Any more?
how to give important importance in respect of which emotion is important for a person and how is it affecting?
सॉरी कम अगेन.
द क्वेश्चन इज कि इमोशंस को कैसे हम चूज करेंगे कि बैकफायर के हिसाब से. आई थिंक दिस इज अ वेरी लॉन्ग थिंग.
नो
दिस
नो
इज
नो इट्स
नॉट.
नॉट लॉन्ग. दिस इज व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. देर आर वेरियस इमोशंस विच यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. इट डजेंट इट्स नॉट ओनली लिमिटेड टू फियर्स एंड एंगर्स एंड एंग्जाइटी माई डियर. इट्स सो मच अबाउट डिनायल्स एंड रिजेंटमेंट्स एंड कॉम्प्रिहेंसिवनेस एंड मैनिपुलेटिवनेस. द हिडन वरीज आर देयर. देर इज ग्लूमीनेस. देर इज मूडीनेस. दीज आर ऑल इमोशंस. देर आर टन्स ऑफ इट. सो यू ही हैज कैटेगराइज एंड पुट इट टूगेदर एंड गिवन अस दिस रेमेडीज टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो देर इज अ कैटेगराइजेशन ऑफ दीज इमोशन. दैट्स वेयर द बैच फ्लावर इज. एनी मोर?
I think for the introduction part, it's perfectly fine. It was really amazing to have you, ma'am. If anyone else has queries, we still have 5-10 minutes. You can just
Yes,
raise your hands. You can just raise your
I
hands.
love to answer queries. Yes.
Ma'am, are you there
you
on
can...
YouTube also?
Yes.
Are you there
very
on
much.
YouTube also?
Yes,
By which
very
name?
Much.
Dr. Jyoti.
Yes, by by Jyoti Clinics.
Backflower remedies by Dr.
by
Jyoti.
The name of Jyoti Clinics.
Yeah.
Someone has asked, instead of placebo, can we use backflowers? I think yes. It's not.
No, Dr. Akshita, I beg to differ. Please, it's not about placebo equal to BFR. No.
Yeah, equally,
no.
But
no. Instead, no. It's not like that. If you allow me to answer, Dr. Akshita, can I?
Yes, ma'am, please, surely.
Yeah, yeah. See, this is not a replacement for placebo at all. So you mean to say they have no action? We are just giving it for the satisfaction of a person? No. We are treating the emotion, my dear. My dear doctor, whosoever has asked, let me tell you, batch flower works as a remedy, not as a placebo. So it takes care of the emotion very strongly. And that is how homeopathic medicine, which is given as an adjuvant, or any other therapy which is given as an adjuvant, starts working curatively, and it enhances the process of complete cure, is what I would say.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
It's okay.
Like, you know, I am being using these medicines along with the homeopathy. Like, whenever I have to give constitution, I give that constitution.
Correct.
And then, you know, instead of giving like a plain placebo, you know, where I see there is a lot of pain in a patient, physical pain, you know, then I try and use a rescue remedy. Again, when I want, you know, if a child is there, he's in a changing phase, then I try to use walnut. So, as you say, I use it with this intention of okay, it will enhance the remedy. But, you know,
Tell me.
I doesn't mean that wo khali placebo effect ke liye. No, definitely it will help with the homeopathy.
Yeah, but when you said if a child is crying and then you gave this particular, for that, the understanding of every remedy is very important. Every batch flower's emotion has to be understood.
But not crying, ma'am. Like he's in a changing phase.
Huh?
Like when we gave it in during adolescence, so wo changing period hai na.
Mm-hmm.
So what I have studied, I have not done. I have just read very superficially. So tabhi walnut is always help to adopt the changeability phase in the life.
Yes. What happens, no? Whenever any case comes, first you have to understand the core. It works like an onion peeling method. So when the remedies will keep changing as it shows its effect. So it is always good to start with what was the basic problem emotionally and why the physical symptoms have come up. So when you choose a batch flower remedy, it starts peeling off. It starts opening up the case and shows us the different sides or different angles of the patient to us. And that's where even a proper homeopathic remedy starts playing its role. And at the same time, the batch flower starts changing. So there is a period of change also. It's not necessary that you have to give that batch flower which you have begun till the end. It will have its changing modes. Just like in homeopathy, understand?
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
Intercurrent has to be given. Intercurrent has to be given, right? We have to understand the anti-miasmatic background. everything plays an important role. It's not only the constitution which works. So in homeopathy also, we have to understand the core, the miasm, the sphere of action, all of it. It's the same.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah. I am using as a rescue remedy.
Now that's the issue. Everybody just wants to use rescue remedy because of the word rescue. So rescue de diya homeopathy.
Yeah.
But that's not the beginning and the end of BFR. There is loads. See, let me tell you in a poetic manner, it's more than the look and the essence of the flower. The flower tells us more. The batch flower tells us more about it. There is more to it. So the emotion has to be understood in every flower. And only then you can select. When somebody is not capable of selecting the correct remedy, that is the time people end up giving rescue.
So one gastric patient was there, and he was gallbladder calculus, and he was suffering severe lot of pain. I gave medicine homeopathy, but second day she came again, and I gave rescue. She was okay. After 1 week, she came. She was okay.
Yes, but what happens is that is not the way batch flower is given, my dear. That is what I'm trying to tell you. That is why I made up all these slides to basically let you understand there is an in-depth study. So I really want you people to enjoy the studying process. It's so interesting to understand the emotion of every remedy, and then it becomes easier for you to implement it. It's such a beautiful journey. I have been enjoying this journey for last all these years. And homeopathy has enhanced because of that.
Yeah, yes. Mental healing and physical healing in both rescue remedies working very well.
Yes.
With mental, emotional, every emotions, I am giving rescue.
I would still, then I must urge you, you should join the upcoming module.
It is my favorite medicine.
I would definitely urge. Yes, any more? Any more questions?
Thank you very much. Very nice, and you gave a very nice lecture.
If homeopathy can sort out, why batch flower?
Okay, very good. Homeopathy, how many remedies, how many medicines you know at the click of your finger?
Please, let's open the discussion. You can unmute yourselves.
Why not?
Can you stop share so that I can put the calculator.
I'll do that. I'll just do that. 1 minute. Stop
because
share.
Everyone can be seen then.
Okay.
Professor, you can just put on your videos and you can just have an open discussion.
Yes. Why not? Yes.
Ma'am, you can answer till then.
Sure. How many remedies are there in homeopathy? If I ask the person who has asked me this question,
so many.
Don't tell me so many, or then don't tell me thousands, or don't tell me a vague figure. Are you aware how many?
More than 2,500.
No. Now her answer is more than 2,000. Somebody else is saying 3,000. Somebody will.
Unaccountable.
So many of them, right? Do you know? Do you understand?
So many medicines.
Yes. So
there are many rare medicines.
Correct. There are so many innovative medicines. So many rare medicines. There are groups of medicine. There are so many which we as practicing doctors also may have not used them. Till today, I'm telling you. And see, I'm one of the practitioners who like to teach homeopathy or batch flower, not only by the success cases, let me tell you, but also by the failures, what has happened in homeopathy. Because that is something which people don't discuss or don't like to openly talk about. Let me tell you, there are a lot of failures and which has given us a helping hand to read more, to understand more. And that's how we are better today. And I'm sure we'll be much better tomorrow. Because we have understood, we have to read what, where, and implement when. So 38 remedies are the easiest way to understand the feelings of a person. And that caters to everything. See, he has been very, very strict in his application. He said, do not think there is something going beyond 38 remedies. He stopped. He had the time. He stopped in 1934. His research. He wrote down everything. And he said, I have nothing more to find. I know this is complete cure by itself. Every case will be handled because there is no more emotion to add. And that's why in his books, it is written by Dr. Stephen Ball that earlier it was diphtheria or tuberculosis and today we have cancer and COVID, but the feelings remain the same. The names of the diseases have evolved. That is the change. Yeah. That is the change.
Yeah, it's correct. Correct.
Yes. So why BFR is this?
You mean that you can treat all the diseases with veg flour? Only with veg flour?
See, basically, wherever, in acute, chronic or whichever case, if the base is of mind, something which has come up from a mind, something which has come up due to an emotion, definitely batch flour plays its role. Now, if you ask me, every case of homeopathy, we definitely try to find where is the starting point, ailment from, correct? And many a times, the causative, factors, we try to find, right? Because that helps us derive. Like we do the location, the sensation, the modality and the concomitants, what we try to find is the ailment from, right? And in that ailment from, if emotion ailment is the crux, the crux, batch flower plays a very important role.
So if you are not able to...
What about delusion? Delusion?
Then we can't prescribe.
Sorry?
Then we can't prescribe.
Sorry?
Suppose in a case, we are not able to locate any emotional factors.
Yes.
Then we can't prescribe batch flower remedies.
Then you cannot start with a batch flower at that moment.
Yeah.
You have to come to an acute remedy. Am I right? Even now it happens, no? See, in all the case takings, do you think every patient tells us very nicely and very detailed study about the mind? Never. It doesn't happen. All the cases do not tell us mind. And that is where a homeopath could go wrong. Phir hota kya hai? Hum kya karte? Mind nahi mil raha hai, to khodna shuru kar dete. Wo patient ke andar andar khodte. Mind bolo. Aur kya ho raha hai? It's not like that. See,
में क्या अच्छा लगता है? बस सबसे पहले खाने में क्या अच्छा लगता है? क्या खाना अच्छा लगता है? अब खाने के लिए क्या पूछे?
Most important is if a person is suffering, if they are suffering, no, they will tell you. समझे आप? If they are suffering, they will tell you. Because they are suffering.
First two lines mein they will take.
They will. And if they don't have an emotional background because of which they feel something has happened, they will not tell you. They will not.
Yes.
So maybe during your second sitting, maybe during your third sitting, they may become completely. This could happen. You're right, Dr. Mamta. But at times I'm saying first sitting.
When patient will come alone, patient is coming with family, it is not possible to tell everything for every patient.
Exactly.
If he is alone, then he can commit the...
Aajkal patients alone bhi aate hai. Kaafi aate hai.
Can.
But yet they don't. Because see, there are two, three things to it. One is they don't feel it's important. That's why they don't say. Second thing is they are not comfortable sharing it in the first sitting. Third, they feel okay, abhi is cheez ki koi zarurat hai hi nahi, baad mein dekha jayega. So there are various reasons which a doctor has to understand, a homeopath has to understand this.
What type of delusion, what type of fear, what type of anxiety is delusion.
So for that you have to understand, no, his feeling, his representation. We have to stop assuming. Agar bahut bar ye hota hai, agar a case of paralysis or strokes are there and agar that person has been suppressing his anger or his emotions, hum usko category mein bitha dete hai, ye sab uske suppression of thoughts se hua hai. This is our assumptions. Agar us bande ko waisa kabhi feel hi nahi hua hoga to kya pata? बोलते अरे इसकी वाइफ तो बहुत डोमिनेटिंग है, इसने तो उसको पूरा सप्रेस कर डाला है, इसलिए उसको नर्व का अफेक्शन हुआ है. बट अगर उसे फील नहीं ये हो रहा है तो फील हमने को अपने को क्यों हो रहा है? मतलब ये हमारा बायस नेचर है या हमारा थॉट है और हमारा कौन है जो नहीं होना चाहिए. When we are
वो हम अपने आप इंटरप्रिटेशन कर लेते हैं ना,
नहीं करना चाहिए ना,
इंटरप्रिटेशन हम अपने आप ही कर लेते हैं.
सो डोंट कन्वर्ट इट, दैट्स व्हाट आई एम सेइंग. राइट डाउन द वे,
नहीं करना चाहिए,
नहीं करना चाहिए. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज ऑलवेज सेड ना, घर का अगर डॉक्टर है और घर का पेशेंट है, इट इज बेटर दैट ही गोज टू समबडी एल्स. देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग, बिकॉज वी आर बायस्ड टुवर्ड्स आवर पीपल. वी आर वेरी बायस्ड, वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट पर्सन थ्रू दैट आवर आईज. Whereas another person will look through her eyes. There is a lot of difference here. Lot of difference. So don't feel ever offended to send your family members to another doctor. There is no harm. That doesn't put you down. Okay?
Yeah.
That's an acceptance. Yes.
Dr. Jyoti?
Yes.
Dr. Jyoti?
Fabulous.
Yes, Dr. Sucharitra. Thank you, dear. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Doctor,
thanks for today's
fabulous
webinar.
Thank you.
Very
thanks.
Good, very beautiful.
Thank
and lecture is also very nice, impressive. No, no whatever doubt. I am telling you, everything is fine.
Thank you. This was just a teaser. This was just a jhalak. पूरी पिक्चर तो बाकी है मेरे दोस्त.
No, it was really a wonderful session.
अभी तो ट्रेलर है. This is a trailer.
Thank you.
Yes.
Yeah, Dr. Jyoti, I just have one query.
Hanji.
If a patient is not having any, you know, mental trauma or emotional, you know, ups and downs, and he is only suffering from physical trauma, so can we still think of giving bachflower remedy in that case?
I'll tell you this. Dr. Dr. Sucharitra has always said one thing. It is based on the feeling. He never said it is based on a particular disease. So only if you understand the feeling, batch flower starts playing its role. Till then, he has never said, I have treated my migraine or I have treated some physical ailment. No. If you have understood the feeling, you will choose the right batch flower remedy. And trust me, automatically his physical symptoms have also seen to be vanishing. You will feel it as a miracle. Okay. So many of my patients in the beginning when they come to me and if they are not able to elicit any of the mental symptoms and if I have understood their feeling, if I could touch their core even a little bit and I start off with a batch flower remedy, trust me, I have seen beautiful examples. They come up the next time saying ki abhi waisa nahi feel ho raha hai jo pehle diya tha. There are many patients who say wo chota goli ke saath aap dropper mein dete ho na, wo definitely dena doctor, wo definitely dena.
Yes.
See, these are various kinds the patient represents and tells me. I have seen this happening over last all these years, and that's why I'm so passionate about it. And that's why I want to create more and more awareness about this. And that's why I'm very much eager that each one of you should learn it, but thoroughly.
Right.
I think somebody had written Thank about you. Certain.
Actually, one research. More question.
Haan, bolo. Yes.
Yeah. Excuse me, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, Dr. Sunita. Yes, Dr. Sunita.
Bachelor medicine, we can say it's the complementary to homeopathic medicine.
Absolutely.
And what I feel that what you said just now, that it is based on basically on emotions. So it's mainly used in psychosomatic diseases. We can say so.
Yes, and, of course.
What about pathological cases?
If you remember one of my slides where I have mentioned the link between endocrine system, the nervous system and the immune system. You remember? And that's where it says that it can treat any pathology. You remember? I said thyroid hai, PCOS hai. Yes, it treats provided we know what the patient is delivering to us in the feeling form.
Cancer se bada pathological kya ho jo aapke paas aapne treat kiya hai?
See, I have
cancer.
Yes, I'm telling you, when I started
started from cancer, and that is also pathological.
Absolutely. Aur kya chahiye?
So, usse bada aur kya chahiye? Proof aapko.
Thank you so much, Dr. Mamta. I'm really telling you, when I used to be on treatment, you know, every time chemo ka hota tha or whatever side effects used to happen, one thing I used to tell my doctor, for this doctor, I'm taking homeopathy and I'm taking my remedia. And he used to say, Baba, lo Baba, you take your therapy, par ye complete karna. So I used to thank him. And then after those 3 weeks, I used to go back and say, see, I'm feeling fine. Then he used to say, wow, great. Ye kya hai magic? I said, magic potion to hai. Because I didn't want to take the Duflex and I didn't want to take any of their medicine because for a side effect of chemo or a side effect of tamoxifen or an Arimidex, that was not the resolution. What I had to treat was my feeling for it. And the biotissue.
I am giving bad effects of COVID.
Yes.
I am giving bad effects of COVID.
Very important. I am going to cover which remedies are very useful for COVID in our mood.
Yeah.
Dr. Akshita, COVID. We will be sending you. We will be sending you the later on the upcoming events, and I will tell you in what modules what I'll be taking the remedies, the materia medica, the groups, how you're going to categorize it, and then telling you various my own experiences in my clinical practice as well as various others where you can combine homeopathy and various biotissue salts along with BFR also. I'm an avid practitioner with biotissue salts also. I was privileged to be under Dr. Muzumdar, who used to practice this biotissue salts very, very effectively.
That is Dr. Muzumdar in Calcutta, no?
Yeah, he when he was here in Calcutta. Mumbai for his sessions.
I was there. I was sitting there. I was in Dr. Muzumdar's clinic and where I was sitting there.
Exactly. So this is what I'm saying. So
Dr. Majumdar's time.
Biotissue is so important too. So it's a great.
I was in National Institute of Calcutta.
This is Facebook Live. Yes. Thanks for discussion.
Yes.
We should get over for the day. This Facebook Live and all.
Before signing off, I want to really thank a few people. First and foremost, Dr. Akshita. That's because I'll tell you something. This is very important to
be conducted very nicely.
Very well. And second thing is she took care that there was a good flow to the whole session. And we could take up lots of these questions at the end. So
this is the major part which is always missed in webinars. People don't need it. That is the major feel because everyone wants to express. If we are not discussing, then what's the use of these webinars?
Correct.
Next, he's seeing every question. See,
politely. I always feel speakers should speak less and answer more. Because that is what everyone is filled in.
That is what I tried because I love that is what I love doing at the end of discussion. See, teaching is one aspect.
Absolutely.
And conversing and solving your doubts is another aspect which is very important. And that's why
I said everyone come
introduction
on.
Introduction is also very important.
So that one we can discuss everywhere.
Yes. So thank you, Dr. Akshita, not only for conducting, but giving this platform for all of us so that this introduction of Batch Flower could be given to so many and more awareness and creativity is going to happen in healing techniques along with all of us in homeopathy. Remember one thing, till last year, let me be very frank, homeopathy bhi log alag drushtikon se dekh rahe the. लेकिन जब कोविड में हमने हमारा झंडा गाड़ दिया और दिखाया कि हम भी किसी से कम नहीं, इवन फॉर अक्यूट केसेस, दैट इज द टाइम पीपल स्टार्टेड फीलिंग, अरे होम्योपैथी में ये तो बेटर है यार, इसका तो साइड इफेक्ट तो नहीं होता है, अभी वो ही दो, मेरे बच्चे को तो इधर से ही स्टार्ट करो, मेरे नेबर को ये हो रहा है, उसको जाना नहीं है हॉस्पिटल में. सब आई हैव वर्क विद ग्रुप्स ऑफ पीपल फॉर द कोविड पेशेंट्स हु आर इन आईसीयू ऑल्सो, एंड आई एम सो हैप्पी टू हैव ट्रीटेड देम. So thank you to Dr. Akshita. Secondly, I would love and be very, very thankful to Dr. Ketki and her husband Kaustubh and her entire family, both the daughters, who were so helpful with me to create the PPTs, and my niece Riddhi Debri, who helped me create the PPTs. I'm really thankful from the bottom of my heart, and my daughter who supported me in all these things. Mama, you should do it. You love to give knowledge, You love to share what you have. So please do it. Because I believe sharing is caring. And when we are together,
yes,
it goes to the next level. So thank you to each and everyone who have been here and been together.
Ma'am.